Welcome to MCN and the 2018 Honda CB1000R. Now, one of the first jobs we've got to do is try and figure out what this bike is, because for many years people have been yearning a naked Fireblade, and this isn't that bike. This is kind of a strange mix of kind of retro futuristic styling mixed in with kind of a sports naked package. So it's not on par with a super naked like an Aprilia 210, KTM Super Duke, Yamaha MT10 or BMW S1000R. Hasn't really got the poise and the handling and the power to compete with those bikes. But what it does do is kick the butts of the current generation of retro bikes like the Triumph Thruxton, the BMW R9T, the Kawasaki Z900 RS and the Scrambler 1100. So it's kind of a really nice mix of sports naked and stylish retro, and I think it's all the better for it. There's plenty of super nakeds in the world. I don't think really we need another one. And Honda have gone their own path with this bike, and they've done a really nice job. And the best thing about it, the absolute best thing about this bike, is the way it looks and the way it's built. This is Honda quality and attention to detail at its very, very best. This bike sums up why people say Hondas are beautifully built. The devil is in the detail for this bike. So you've got a beautiful black paint finish that looks like it's literally come out of the gun. There's brushed alloy panelling, the saddle's beautifully stitched, there's embossed radiator guard and seat back logos. The elegant new subframe features pillion grab handle cutouts, and the funky clocks are a 70s tomorrow's world glimpse into the future. And that slash cut exhaust looks and sounds so good, there's no need to go aftermarket. LED headlights feature old school cooling fins, even though they're not needed, and together with the rear light they're so thin the snub-nosed bodywork is smaller and more compact. The red spring shower shock screams Zazu-grade our factory superbike, and everything from the alley single-sided swing arm pivot plates to the engine covers look anything but mass-produced. Now, happily, the bike goes as well as it looks. It's powered by the same engine as the previous CB1000R, which is basically a 2006 Fireblade lump. And the reason they've kept that engine is because it's got a longer stroke, and the longer stroke is what you need to have more torque and nice road manners. The newer blade's got a shorter stroke engine, so it's a little bit more revvy. But Honda have reworked the engine. It's got another 12 horsepower, it's got more grunt, between 6,000 and 8,000 revs, and it's got riper wire as well. And that riper wire throttle response is really, really smooth. The engine is really smooth overall. It's very familiar as an inline four. If you've ridden a big inline four, you'll be instantly at home on the CB1000R. Okay, it hasn't got the character of a twin, a triple, or a cross-plane crank, but it's got loads of grunt, it's easy to use, got a very smooth gearbox, and it's very fast. In actual fact, it pulls really nice wheelies, and of all the nanny state electronics that are fitted to bikes nowadays, it's quite ironic that kind of a safe, sensible Honda will let you pull wheelies as well as give you traction control support. And that's really down to the fact it hasn't got an IMU corner insensitive system. IMUs are really good to give you accurate traction control and wheelie control, but sometimes it sucks the fun out of a bike. The new bike's got a new chassis, it's got new wheels, bigger rear tyre, it's got a 190/55 instead of a 180, and it's actually got a taller profile than the Fireblade, so you've got more of a balloon shaped tyre and more side grip. The bike is quite small, quite squat, it's very comfortable. The bars are a little bit narrower than you'd imagine on a bike like this, but you quickly get used to it. And the riding position is so natural, you don't really notice it, you don't give it a second thought. The seat's pretty comfortable. After a while you start getting numb bump, but that's not until sort of 5, 6, 7 hours, so it's perfectly acceptable for this kind of bike. And the handling is really neutral, as you'd expect from a bike like this. It's not pin sharp, it's not the last word in grip or poise, but it's very light steering, very neutral. You know exactly what's going to happen, and you've got adjustable suspension to dial it in if you want. You've got a new shower big piston forks at the front with compression and rebound damping in the left leg, preload in the right leg, and at the rear you've got an adjustable shock. It hasn't got compression adjustment, just rebound and preload, but it could all be set up nice and stiff. You could put sticky tyres on it and have a lot of fun. There's a lot of ground clearance, so you're not going to worry about scraping the pegs anytime soon. You've got four riding modes. You've got riding modes that started off on the RCV and then trickled down to the Fireblade, the Africa Twin, the Goldwing. You've got the three modes which have got ascending levels of power, engine braking control and traction control. But you've also got a user mode where you can adjust those settings to suit, so you can turn all the electronics off if you want. There's also a CB1000R Plus model, which has got a quick shifter and an auto blipper, which works beautifully smoothly and goes really well with that old school engine. And you've got heated grips and a number of cosmetic updates, and that adds about £1,000 to the bike. So here in spring 2018, the base model bike is £11,300, give or take a pound, and the plus model is £12,300. There's not much to criticise on a new bike other than that price, really. So most of its kind of naked Japanese rivals, most of its retro rivals are all a fair chunk cheaper. But like I said at the beginning, you do get what you pay for this bike, so it's going to cost a little bit more to buy. Perhaps not so much if you get it on finance or PCP, you won't notice the increase in price so much, but you get a lot of quality parts for your money, and you'll probably spend as much time cleaning and enjoying it and looking at it over a cup of tea as you will actually riding it. So Honda haven't chased super naked glory or gone full retro with the new CB1000R, but by nestling nicely in between the two, they've created a fast, slick, beautifully crafted roadster that's daringly different with a style of its own. It's not the naked blade that some had hoped for, but we reckon it's better for it.